David Musée, and in 2010, I suffered a partial spinal cord injury. I was determined to walk again, but it wasn't just determination that got me here. It was science. And it all started with a bold idea.
I still remember vividly being in front of a paralyzed rat. We were stimulating the spinal cord to restore movement of the paralysis, and the rat starting walking. I understood that there was a path for a treatment that could help people to walk again. I love to publish with Springer Nature because these journals always inspired me, even when I was a young scientist, because I feel that there is a storytelling, and this is shaped with integrity, trusted process, and from my experience, editors were really helping you to craft a manuscript that would be really compelling and can be shared with the scientific community.
When I met Grégoire, my mission was to apply with him these new therapies to the human being. So the challenge to bring this digital bridge together was, first of all, for me being a neurosurgeon, to find the right technology that was not aggressive for the patient and that was robust over time. So to have an important publication with Springer Nature helps a lot because it's credible. It has been reviewed by our peers, it's recognized, and you've made a major step forward.
This brain-spine interface is really the first time that we give the opportunity to a paralyzed patient to recover voluntary control of their limbs. We do so by collecting brain signals, decoding the intention of the patient to move, and stimulating his spinal cord below the lesion.
The brain-spine interface is great because we can already put this in the hospital. This can become a treatment quite quickly. But the next step after that is trying to move towards a biological cure. We want our work to reach the widest audience possible. We work on these projects for many years, and when they're done, our goal is for them to make an impact for people and to advance the treatments. Being able to look back at the work that we and others have done that's been published and be able to cite that to advance our understanding of the disease, this is the bedrock of science, and publishing with Springer Nature is one of the best ways to do that. Each time we produce a piece of work that's published in one of these excellent journals, it just reinforces the next step.
This is one research project of thousands published by Springer Nature, and it's exciting to see how the work plays an important role in not only solving the problems of today, but also in inspiring the research of tomorrow. I am one of 174,000 plus editors working across the globe, and together we work on close to 1.2 million peer reviews, sometimes handling over 2.3 million submissions, of which a small amount gets published. Our job is to bring important research to life, to ensure integrity of the work, and make sure it reaches the people who need it. We also provide technology-enabled products, platforms, and services that help researchers to uncover new ideas and share their discoveries with health professionals to stay at the forefront of medical science and educators to advance learning.
While seeing the whole field of science progress and continue to push the limits is fantastic. I think it's a good thing in science, but also in general life, and it's important to do so, and it's cool to be part of it.
What starts as a breakthrough in the lab can become a moment of hope in someone's life and a spark for scientists of the future. That's why at Springer Nature, we support millions of researchers, clinicians, and educators who bring that spark to life, bringing greater understanding to the world, helping us all be part of progress.